it's not just Battlefront that we have to look forward to this year, guys. We've got a lot of novels and a lot of comics, TV shows, a movie, games. We got everything coming out this year. You know, the last few years, it's been comics, novels, movie. That's been about it, right? You know, and if you don't count Battlefront content coming out, stuff like that. So this year, we are getting so much Star Wars goodness. It's insane. And these are in chronological order, in the order they're coming out in this year. They're not in, you know, any order by novels, TV shows, anything like that. So we're just going to start at the top and work our way down. This is everything that has been announced so far. This isn't everything by any means. You know, at Celebration, we're going to be getting announcements for, you know, more comics, more novels, you know, whatnot. So this is just what we know of so far. So starting on March 5th, we have a novel coming out by E.K. Johnston called Queen's Shadow. I'm very excited about this one. This is a novel that follows Padme Amidala after her years as Queen of Naboo. So it takes place between episodes 1 and 2. And it's her trying to learn to be a senator after being a queen, you know. And I think this is my prediction. I see it being more of everybody else trying to come to terms that she's no longer royalty and treating her like a senator instead of a queen, you know. So she's trying to get out from under that shadow, if you know what I mean. I'm really looking forward to this novel. We really don't have a lot of Padme-centric stuff. You know, she had a huge part in Thrawn Alliances and obviously a big part in Clone Wars, but that's really about it. We haven't really seen a lot of Padme anywhere, to be honest. So I am excited about this novel, and especially E.K. Johnston writing it. She did Ahsoka, which I absolutely loved the novel Ahsoka. So we have that one to look forward to. Between April 11th and April 15th, we are going to be having Star Wars Celebration Chicago 2019. I'm very, very excited for Celebration this year. You know, the last Celebration was kind of a letdown for a lot of people, you know. Yeah, we got the trailer for Last Jedi, and it was the 40th anniversary panel. But that was really about the only thing that stood out for that Celebration. You know what I mean? Because if I remember right, I believe that was also the Celebration where they brought Alden Ehrenreich out and was like, here's your new Han Solo, and we all already knew, you know, so that was no shocker. So I feel like that was a real letdown, you know, because we didn't get any Obi-Wan announcement, which everybody thought we were going to get. So I have a feeling they're going to try to make up for it with it this year. Obviously, we're going to be getting a trailer for Episode 9. Yes, I can't wait. Obviously, we're going to get more comic announcements, more novel announcements. Maybe we'll see a little something from Jedi Fallen Order. Doubt it. Maybe that'll be E3, but you never know. You know, maybe some images from it or something like that. Very, very excited about that. And maybe some film announcements. Fingers crossed. I don't know. Who knows? You know, so Celebration 2019 is going to be April 11th to the 15th. April 16th, the day after Celebration ends, we have got one of my most anticipated novels of 2019 that we know of so far, and that is Master and Apprentice by Claudia Gray. This is a novel I am so stupidly excited for that this is what I want. Like, I'm starting to get this weird itch in my neck that I have to scratch because I want this book so bad. And for those of you that don't know, Claudia Gray is the queen of canon, in my opinion. You know, she wrote Lost Stars, Bloodline. She wrote Leia, Princess of Alderaan. She did the short story Master and Apprentice in the novelette, the set of short stories from a certain point of view, following Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon during A New Hope, which was really, really kind of a cool aspect to see. So I'm really, really looking forward to this novel. This novel is going to take place pre-Phantom Menace, though. So this is going to be the first novel we have before Episode 1. We've got a couple of comic runs. You know, we had a few issues in the Star Wars comic that followed Yoda pre-Phantom Menace, and we've had the 5-issue Darth Maul run that was pre-Phantom Menace. But this will be the first novel we've had that is pre-Phantom Menace. So I'm very, very excited about that. June 4th, we've got Alphabet Squadron by Alexander Freed coming out. Not a whole lot is known about this novel at this point. Alexander Freed did the Rogue One novelization. He did the first Battlefront novel. So I'm looking forward to this novel. And I felt like an idiot trying to figure out why it was called Alphabet Squadron until I realized that it's a squadron of different starfighters, like an A-wing, a B-wing, an X-wing, you know, stuff like that. So, but I'm really looking forward to that novel as well. The last novel that we know of at this moment, as of this recording, is July 23rd. That is the third in the Thrawn series, Thrawn Treason by Timothy Zahn. I'm so looking forward to this novel. I cannot wait. The Thrawn series so far, been phenomenal. It's no different than what it was in the old EU. Obviously, Timothy Zahn is a genius for writing a character like Thrawn. Because when you read Thrawn, yes, he's a military genius. But you got to think about it. We all know Thrawn's a fictional character. Zahn is writing this guy. Zahn is a genius to be able to write some of this stuff. So I am so stupidly looking forward to that. Fall of 2019, we're going to have the launch of the Disney streaming service. And on that streaming service, we are going to be having Jon Favreau's The Mandalorian making its premiere, as well as season 7 of Clone Wars. Clone Wars is making its return. I'm so excited for that. Look, I'm looking forward to The Mandalorian, especially hearing that, you know, IG-88's going to be in it, possibly Bossk. You know, I mean, all these rumors we've been hearing about The Mandalorian. So excited for it. But Clone Wars Season 7, holy crap. Hold my beer, watch this. I cannot wait for Season 7 of Clone Wars, which we will talk about a little bit more when I get to the mailbag section. But yeah, man, this is a show. This is a long time coming. And look, I defend a lot of what Disney does, right? I tell a lot of people, calm down, it'll happen. But look, Clone Wars is one of these things where even I was like, man, this needs to happen. Why the hell are we not getting an end to Clone Wars? And now we finally are. So I'm really, really excited about it. I think I'm more excited for Clone Wars than I am Mandalorian. I'm really going to say it. I'm really excited for Mandalorian, but Clone Wars, it's got a special place in my heart. Especially considering now, you know, for the patrons, I'm sitting down and doing after shows. We're watching Clone Wars together. So, and I know I'm only 2 episodes into Clone Wars again, rewatching it. But hopefully I'm done with Clone Wars by the time we get to Season 7. So I'm really, really excited for that. Holiday of 2019, we're going to have the video game release of Jedi Fallen Order. I know EA takes a lot of crap for Battlefront 2, and some of it is deserved. I know that. A lot of it's not, I don't think. But I'm really excited to see what they do with Jedi Fallen Order, especially considering that this is going to be a story-driven game, not just multiplayer-driven like Battlefront is. I'm really, really looking forward to Jedi Fallen Order. We know next to nothing about this game, so maybe we'll get some information at Celebration, E3 definitely, but this year we're going to finally start seeing some gameplay, some trailers maybe, obviously a trailer at some point of Jedi Fallen Order. So stupidly excited for that. We don't have a release date for that yet, but we do know it's going to be holiday of 2019, obviously this year. And it all leads up to the creme de la creme, the big finale this year, something I never thought I'd see ever. I never thought I'd be talking about episode 9, Star Wars episode 9. You know, I grew up with episodes 1. Well, I grew up with Star Wars Empire and Jedi. And then, you know, as I got older, it was, oh, now it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, I never thought I'd be talking about episode 9. You know what I mean? So we have got the conclusion of the Skywalker saga on December 20th, Star Wars episode 9. I'm so stupidly excited for this as well. I mean, yeah, speculation is running rampant right now. Even I'm one of these people that tries to keep my expectations kind of tempered, but even I'm starting to lose my mind over this. So it's going to be a huge year. And that's not even counting the Cassian Andor series going into production in October, you know, and other novels that haven't been announced yet, which we'll probably find out about at Celebration. Other comics, you know, that we'll probably find out about at Celebration. You know, stuff like Vader Dark Visions. I'm so excited for Vader Dark Visions. It's insane. I cannot wait. So that is everything as of now that we have to look forward to. I'm sure I'm going to have to update that list come Celebration when they start talking about some new thing. You know, we're going to get 2 or 3, maybe 4 novel announcements. And you know, and definitely some more comic issue or some more comic announcements. Because at this point, by the time Celebration rolls around, as of now, the only ongoing series they're going to be having going for comics is going to be the Star Wars comic Dr. Aphra, which I still can't figure out how that one's still going. To be honest, we're on issue like 28 or something like that of Dr. Aphra, and Vader has yet to get past issue 25. I don't know, but anyway, we're gonna have Star Wars Dr. Aphra, and whether or not Han Solo Imperial Cadet keeps going, I'm not sure if that's supposed to be a 5-issue run or a limit or like a limited run or an ongoing. I'm not sure, but that's really about it. So, and then we've got this Age of Republic, Age of Rebellion, and Age of Resistance series going. We're gonna have to get some announcements of what's going to come after that. So, very, very excited to see what comes out of Celebration and what we have to look forward to this year, man. I can't wait. I know I keep saying it, man. I can't wait. I'm so excited.